following up on today's seminar, I wanted to ask you about why is it important that people would be more engaged in democratic processes and lawmaking?
I think it's extremely important that people be involved, and that means diverse people from all walks of life and society, because we need their expertise to solve problems. It's not simply about a democratic nice to have to build legitimacy. It's really about creating more effective policies that are quality laws with better quality outcomes. Depends on really tapping into the ideas and expertise that people have throughout society. It's not enough simply to engage with interest groups. It's important to really get at the know-how that individuals have from their experience, from their education, from their professions. We all have a lot to share to help solve problems faster, with more innovative solutions, and more effectively.
And what are some of the methods that people can contribute to the democratic processes? Do we have any good examples from around the world?
We're seeing lots of examples from around the world at every stage of the legislative or policymaking process. So in Taiwan, the V Taiwan process engages people participating both online and off, first in identifying the problem and setting the agenda, identifying those issues that are of the greatest and most urgent importance. In New York City, they're using big data, listening to the social media data and the data that comes from citizen complaints to really understand what are the most important problems and what are the highest priorities that citizens are facing. In other places like Iceland, of course, not far from here, they are using new tools to engage with citizens in identifying solutions to those problems. In Mexico, there are great examples in places like Monterrey, Mexico, a large city of about 150,000 people, where civil servants are engaging with citizens, again, online and off, having identified the problems to say, what are the most innovative ways in which we can reduce traffic, reduce pollution, shorten the amount of time it takes kids to go to school? And then we're seeing examples in places like Brazil, where they're actually using online tools to both source those problems and solutions that the parliament can actually use through a platform like Mudamos. One last example, also in Brazil, they've had an experience with then giving the charge to school children to evaluate the success of the law on healthy school lunches. So what a lot of parliaments, legislatures, city councils do is they pass a law, but then they forget about it until the next election. What if we actually engaged with citizens in monitoring, in evaluating, in assessing, are those laws actually working the way that they're doing in Brazil, the way that TransGov is doing in Ghana, and the way that social auditing is being done, as it's called, in both the Philippines and in Italy, again, to assess what's working, how is it working, and how can we evolve our policies and our laws to make them more effective.
And you have spent a few days now in Estonia and had a numerous discussion about digital governance here in Estonia. So what are the few things that we could do better here in Estonia?
Well, Estonia is, of course, known as the mecca of digital governance. It is at the forefront at really not only performing and making government more digital and creating more e-services, putting services online, but I think importantly, inspiring so much of the rest of the world to do so. The idea of an e-governance academy that brings people from around the world to give them the impetus and the skills and the know-how to go home and be able to put their own government services online, maybe even the more important success story. It's not simply what's happened here in Estonia, but what Estonia has inspired to happen in the rest of the world. So now I think the question is whether Estonia can take the next step and also become the leader in e-participation, in e-democracy, if you will, in new, more engaged and collaborative forms of problem solving in the way that Estonia has for the last 10 years been the leader in electronic government.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.